Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Brandon Manning, I'm with High Power Kennels here in Fontana, California. The Cane Corso, the original reason I went to that breed is when I bought my first home, definitely wanted to look into a protective animal, protective dog for the home. So I looked into all kinds of breeds, Dobermans, you know, German Shepherds, all kinds in like, the Presa, and I came to the Cane Corso, a good, powerful, confident dog, and very number one, just protection. Family dog, protection dog. The French Bulldogs, that was more of my fiance. She, you know, I had all these big dogs. She wanted a little dog so she can mingle with. And after looking at all little dogs, never been a fan of little dogs, the French Bulldogs, I liked their little stout character, little confidence in them. And, you know, I wasn't into Chihuahuas or anything like that. But when I see the little French Bulldogs, I was like, all right, I'm cool with that. We can do that. And then, yeah, you see them, little characters. And I'm not going to lie, the French Bulldogs, you know, they run the backyard more than the Cane Corsos do. And it's just kind of funny seeing them in the little atmosphere in the backyard and how they socialize amongst each other. It's always that phrase, little dog syndrome, because little dogs, they run it. It's just the way it works. My two Cane Corsos that I have are males, and the two French Bulldogs that I have are females. So as far as the socialization between them, the females, like I said, I call my little French bulldog the little chola, because she runs the yard, and as long as she okays it, everything else is good. But among socialization between them, I feed them all at the same time. If one dog comes inside, they all come inside. There's no favoritism amongst my dogs. So if one dog goes out, they all go out. So that's the main thing about socializing them, is not showing any favoritism amongst them. They're all treated the same. They all get fed at the same time. They all get put out at the same time, go to bed at the same time. The one thing with my Cane Corsos though, is the main thing I did get them for is for protection. So they all sleep indoors, except one Cane Corso, I rotate them every day, is gonna sleep outside. And that's meant solely for protection of my home. And I mean, that was the purpose of them. So. I mean, they get one day on, one day off, you know, so they rotate, but there is always one at night patrolling the backyard. What makes the Cane Corso a great pet? First and foremost is their family socialization. As long as when it came to my daughter, younger kids, great with children, very, a lot of patience they have with them. But them being such a large breed, you know, people are very hesitant when they see them, which is a good thing. As far as, you know, people coming, people I don't know, strangers, intruders, whatever, right off the bat, you see that breed and you're like, I'm probably not gonna go in that house, right? But the minute I bring you into my home and they acknowledge that this is not a stranger, I'm okay with them in the house, me being the dominant one in the household, then they're immediately okay. Not that they're keeping their eye off of you, but they're okay with your presence as long as I'm okay with it. Even when I go into my front yard porch, I take my dog, he goes in front with me. They're not escape artists. They don't try jumping fences. They stay in my front lawn. They don't like leaving the territory. And that's one thing I like about them. My daughter goes outside, she rides her bike in the street. My dog's just rolling around with her everywhere. And without taking off or going towards other things that distract them, that's his main priority. That's where he's staying. And what makes a French Bulldog great pet? I would have to say their characteristics, they're always gonna make you like laugh at them at some point. They're goofball, just in their small stature period. The way they carry themselves is just kind of comical, but they're good pets as far as, same thing with my daughter, she goes to sleep, French Bulldog jumps in bed with her, and it's like a life-size cuddle stuffed animal, right? And she loves that, right? She can lay on top of one and then cuddle with the other one in the bed. And yeah, so with them, it's, you get that quality aspect, that small dog and them liking to socialize and nurture, and they're not like other breeds, like smaller breeds that are very like nippy if you come near them. No, they love the attention, they love the belly rubbing, all that good stuff. Well, working with the Cane Corso, they're very high-driven dogs, and they want to please you, and they want a task. So they work best when given guidance. As far as like when I train my dog, when I'm working on his home behavior, and instead of telling your dog, no, don't do that, no, don't do that, no, get off the sofa, tell them what you want them to do. Hey, put them in a sit stay here on their pillow and have them do that. Because in their mind mentality, they're working for you, they're pleasing you. And at the same time, you have a home environment where they're just not knocking over people all over the place. One of my dogs, High Power Striker, he's a very high driven dog. I started off with him as far as showing and confirmation. And as soon as he got a year old, and he championed out, I wanted to get into more of the protection, working stuff. Started off balanced with, got him a CGC, just obedience first. And that's the main thing with Cane Corso, is you want them to be a balanced dog. Once we got his obedience down, then we started working into the protection work. And you know, people, they misinterpret that with aggression, but really, they're just having fun working, doing a command that you ask them to do. And that's simply all that they look at it as. So Cane Corso, they're just a high-driven dog. Give them a task to do, and you know, they'll take care of it and please it, and win-win situation. Because the Cane Corso is just a natural guardian breed, I like to implement that into the day-to-day and how I train them and do working and protection work, just to stick to the natural characteristics that they carry already. When I first got my Cane Corso, I had him in the backyard. For some reason, I didn't understand it. Every night, 9:30, this guy just barks for 5 minutes. And he's not a barker, but for 5 minutes. And then I started seeing the first night, second night, after a week of him doing that, I started realizing, like, man, this guy is just, this is his, he's doing his detail in the backyard. He's letting people know he's back there, he's on guard. And that's just come natural. That's not even something I had to teach them. Or teach him, but then carrying more into that, getting him into the obedience and protection work, it went easily, just being the dog's natural breed instinct. I'm up about 4 o'clock in the morning, so for about 4:30, I'm taking them outside. They're all using the restroom. They're all doing their thing. Like I said, they sleep inside, so take them out to do the restroom. While they're doing that, I prepare all their food, get it ready. Having that many dogs in a household, you know, it's it could be extensive as far as food time goes. So we try teamworking it. I get all the food ready, and then before I leave, put them back in their crate. Let them use the restroom, put them back in the crate inside. When she wakes up about 8 o'clock, again, lets them out, and at that time is when she feeds them all together. And then they're roaming the backyard till she leaves about 10 o'clock. After that, they'll go back in the crate. Again, always having one Cane Corso outside for their patrol time for that day. Depending on who gets home first, around 4 or 5, then we'll let them out again, let them roam, do their thing, have some fun. And at that point, when we're home cooking dinner, socializing, watching TV, all the dogs come inside. And they come inside, they socialize, they spend their time. That's a real big, important thing with this breed, is socialization. And knowing that they're part of the family. They, you know, they work best when you incorporate them in your family. And I mean, not only for the protection aspect that I get them for, you know, but they are our family members, you know. We bring them in here, and, you know, they get to socialize amongst the family. If we're cooking dinner and watching TV, you know, they're doing it with us and roaming around. And it's just one big family, you know? And at that time, you know, they go, and then the whole other day starts over. You know, nighttime comes, they go back, they go to sleep, they go to their pillows. When the next dog goes out on patrol that night, and just a constant rotation of that. Pretty much depending on how our day goes when we get home, whether if I get home first or my fiance gets home first. Some point when we get home, the boys, they love walks. You know, the boys, they love the walks. They're a little bit bigger. The Frenchies, they can wear off a lot of energies just in the backyard. The boys, they like doing their walks. They like doing their patrol checks in the community. So getting home, depending on who gets home first, usually I like to do it. Just my own special personal time with them, take them out. And even both of them, no problem. Everybody say you can walk both of them at the same time. No, if you have a well obedience dog, taking them on walk is not as this big hassle as people might think. And then weekends come around, that's when we get to do some fun stuff, get to the park, get to the beach. And if I'm working on a project around the house, I'm going to Home Depot, I'm taking one of the boys with me. You know, it's always good socialization if you can get them out, just run errands with you. People come up to it, they're always fascinated when they see these big dogs. And you know, even with my protection dog, he's balanced. Like I said, it's not the thing of an aggression when I have him going to a bite command. It's him working and having fun. Now, when he goes out to Home Depot, people come up to him, go over him. And mind you, he was a show confirmation dog first. So he's used to people coming over him, feeling his limbs, checking his mouth, checking his cheek. He's fine with all that. And that's because of the socialization from an early stage on. So at the end of the night, all the dogs will sleep inside the house, you know, knowing that they're part of the family. And one dog is gonna be outside on his patrol. And every night switching off between them. Again, because I'm about fairness. One dog goes outside, they all go outside. One dog comes in, they all come in. As far as the mixture of personalities between the French and the French Bulldogs and Cane Corso, I've noticed, like I said, you have the Frenchies being the females, the boys, the Cane Corso being the males. The males tend to let the females think they're running the yard. You know, they'll submit, they'll get on the back, let the Frenchies jump all over them and play with them. If the Frenchie wants the stick or the toy or the bone, the Frenchie gets the stick or toy or the bone. The boys let them have it, and there's no argument in that. The French Bulldogs, they kind of run the backyard, and the boys, in a sense, let them. But when it comes time to protection, they see somebody over the wall, they see somebody right away, the boys, they take the handle, or they get to that fence first. I feed them a combination of food. I feed them kibble. This is kind of, I don't want to say a secret recipe, but my personal recipe is I feed them kibble. I feed them raw meat. I feed them coconut oil. And I feed them a supplement that I use. It's just pretty much a lot of probiotics, vitamins, and they get that all in one sitting. They get that two times a day. So I'm feeding them in the morning, she's feeding them, and then at night is when they get their second meal. And right now I have a puppy, and I'll introduce goat milk into them just to give them extra calcium for their bones as they get big. You know, these are a big breed. They grow big quick. They need that extra calcium for their bone structure. So as far as the house concerns, different house concerns for the different breeds, when it comes to the Cane Corso, I'd say their biggest thing is the hip dysplasia. So one thing that we do at High Power is all our dogs get pen hip OFA on their elbows before even being considered for breeding. Pen and hip on the hips, OFA on the elbows. Pen and hip is a lot more in depth to knowing the Cane Corso breed, as far as OFA just kind of does a broad mastiff. So the readings can be a little bit, not as detailed as a pen and hip, I would say. That's your best bet. But definitely when you're looking into getting this breed, look into that. Is the dog health tested? At least pen and hip, OFA on elbows, cardiac, eyes. Those are probably the top four things you want to look at. And the good thing about it is I've seen throughout the breeders, everybody has the health of this breed as their number one concern. And another thing I want to harp on as far as when it comes to the Cane Corso and their hips and elbows, before they even reach a year old, stay away from high intensive activity with them. Don't let them jump in and out of the back of your truck or even as puppies, jump off the bed or off the sofa. As though they may want to, you really got to watch out because they're still puppies and they grow so quick. You got to watch out for their limbs and their hips and the elasticity of their joints. You know, you want to be mindful of that. So not a lot of heavy running. Before they even hit a year old, which is usually when their growth caps close, you want to keep them away from the high impact working. Probably the best workout you can do for them is if you got a pool, let them jump in and swim. That's probably the best workout for them. As far as the French Bulldogs, again, breeding, you know, with good dogs, good genetics, you want to keep that first and foremost. with the Bulldogs, the main thing you're looking at is you'll hear some of the, it's that soft palate. It's that oversized soft palate. You know, Bulldogs are completely man-made dogs. Nothing about them, I would say, is natural. So the problem is you have these small dogs carrying the size, soft palate of a larger breed, and that hinders their breathing ability. So they can overheat a lot quicker because they don't have that natural ability to cool themselves down, as you see dogs panting and being able to do that. You know what, as far as the kind of Corso goes, I will say it's not a dog for just your every, you have to be, I would say, an experienced dog handler before you get into the kind of Corso breed. They're a very big, powerful, dominant breed, which you have to be a responsible dog owner in that sense and kind of realize that. For the active person with the active lifestyle, perfect dogs, you know, people misconstrued having a big dog with being lazy. These dogs are far from being big and lazy. They're big dogs, but they're very agile and they're very active. So if you want to go on hikes, you want to take your dog to the beach, they're good for all of that. You can actually have them as an apartment or condo dog. You know, they don't mind being in a crate. They like their crates. I leave my dog's crate open and they'll go in there on their own just because that's their own little shelter home, you know, relaxation time. They know they can relax in there. They're family home dogs, you know. You can have, big as they are, you can have them inside. And, so even if somebody wants to have, knowing that if you live in a condo setting, you're gonna be taking them for their walks at least 2 times a day, you know. So they're pretty well behaved inside the house. You know, once they come in and they're all happy, then 2-3 minutes, they're, you know, they're just laying down on the floor and just enjoying their time with the family. The French Bulldog, that's kind of an all around good dog for just, I would say, anybody. They're not as lazy as maybe the English Bulldogs, where those guys, you can walk them a block and they're done for the day. Frenchies, you know, they got little legs, but they like to move them. You know, they can go to the beach with you. I don't know if I would take them hiking, you know, there's a lot of obstacles for them, but if you want to take them to the beach to actually get around, roll around, be able to go, you know, more than just a block's distance, go for a mile walk or what have you, they can keep up with you with that. But yeah, they're so little, even for the apartment person. I say those would probably be the most ideal dogs for you. The maintenance behind them is so minimal. There's no grooming to them. They're not big shedders. So the advantages of also socializing your dogs inside the house is it's giving them another viewpoint of protection. But my dogs could go from being quiet, laying on the carpet, just snoring away, to the minute they hear somebody come to the door, and right away they're rushing that door to find out. And the good thing I like about the kind of Corsos is they're not, you know that saying, I'll bark, no bite? They're very opposite. They're not big barkers. Now, the French Bulldogs, I look at them more as my alarm. They're gonna be barking, 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 and let me know somebody's in the house. And my kind of Corsos are just gonna take care of business, where my Frenchie is gonna be barking at maybe the intruder from the sofa and not leave the sofa. Not to say all Frenchies are like that, because I've seen some working Frenchies that go for a bite. It's kind of comical. But then again, knowing like what damage really is a Frenchie gonna do, you know, I like having them as part of that alarm aspect on letting me know somebody's in the house. When I have people coming, again, if my dogs are inside at the time, then, and I know who the person is, then I'll have my dog do be in a sit stay, or I'll tell him go lay down on his pillow. And as I bring them in, as people come in to socialize, right away, you know, some people aren't dog people, and I'll get that feeling right off the bat, and then I'll have my dog just go ahead and go in the backyard. If they are and they like dogs, and right away it's like, oh, can I pet it? Then I'll call the dog to come rather than you come to the dog, and I'll have the dog come to you, and you can, they'll smile you, socialize you, and at that point, the minute he sees you're not a threat, you can love on him and socialize with him all you want. I don't leave my dogs inside unattended. I don't give them that chance to misbehave. You know, if I'm inside, you know, I could kind of monitor their behavior. If we leave the house, then you're either in your crate or you're outside. They're not just to roam the house freely. I would say first establish yourself with one kind of Corso. And if you want to get into a second one, you want two males, you don't want to deal with a female here, what have you. It's doable, but you got to be responsible and know the characteristics of the dogs, of the two males. As far as the kind of Corso, I can't talk highly enough about this breed. It's just an all-around, great, well-balanced breed. If you're looking for home protection, if you're looking for activity level, to be able to go out with you hiking, taking to the desert, taking to the river, whatever have you, going to the mountains, they can do all that. And at the same time, I like a bigger animal. But at the same time, protecting your house, getting along with your family. They're not too overly driven to where, I have to work these dogs for 12 hours a day. Just an all-around balanced breed. And as far as the French Bulldogs go, I love their little characteristics. They're good with kids as well. They don't have that overprotection where they just sit on their owner's lap, and if you go to approach the owner, they snap at you, like maybe Chihuahuas do that. They just love as well. They're good as far as temperament wise, and that's the main thing with these breeds is they got really well balanced temperaments, and that's something that's important to me with this breed, and why I'm an advocate for breeding quality kind of Corsos and French Bulldogs.